July 13th, 2015, okay? It's 4:10 p.m. Your TV, because of marketing, says that our local is Memphis. 85 miles away. Now we have a storm coming up here. But you know what? Memphis is 85 miles away. Did you know after about 30 miles, you know, all weather is off. It's just different. And I'm picking up my stuff out here while I'm recording because you see it, I see it live. Okay, that's north. Now you can see the clouds, storms. You know, 4 o'clock, it's usually not this dark until around 7:30. And the weather's coming out of the northwest. And I don't know if the wind just blocked all that out, but Memphis is our local, 86 miles away from us. That's our local. WBBJ is in Jackson, approximately 12 to 14 miles. Oh, I can't see. Is it raining out here? I don't want to get out here and get wet right now. Jackson is 12 to 14 miles right over there, right on the other side of those trees. About 10 miles is Jackson. Now, but our local is 86 miles away over there. The weather we get, they give weather for Arkansas, Mississippi, and Memphis, with about 10 miles outside of Memphis, okay? So that's the fairness of DirecTV's marketing bullshit for the local weather. I mean, I've complained to DirecTV. I've complained to, I emailed the channels, the Memphis channels, telling them, says, you guys show West Tennessee, you even show the name Jackson for Jackson, Tennessee, but the weather stops about maybe 10 miles outside of Memphis when you're in Tennessee. But you got to make sure you get those people in Arkansas and Mississippi because that's your viewing area. Yeah. DirecTV and their bullshit marketing from the, what do you call that? The ratings thing. Whatever the name of that ratings thing was. That's what did it. Okay? Maybe 10, 15, 25 years ago. I don't go 86 miles away to get groceries. I don't go 86 miles to get anything. Yet that's our local. So DirecTV, with their bullshit marketing lies, tells us this is where we get our local weather. And if we have a severe tornado around here, oh yeah, it'll cut in at the bottom of the screen. Okay, I'm going in. The wind's picking up out here and the rain's blowing underneath here. Oh, yep. So, rain just now coming down. Newspaper to dry our vegetables and all that on time to time, but I just got that all half-assed. Oh well. Yeah, and that means our power will probably go out. Gibson Electric membership, power usually goes out when there's a storm. Internet usually goes out when there's a storm. The quality service you get in West Tennessee is just like, I don't know. You could probably burn me with a hot poker and I might get better satisfaction. So, I don't want to get in trouble with copyright or anything because, see, there you go. Right there is what I'm talking about. So, storm comes up. We're screwed either way. We can't even watch Memphis's weather because, oh, the satellite, you know, the weather is so bad, and it just blocks out your picture. And then the internet goes out, and it's like, you know what? Stick your thumb up your ass. What a crack of shit. Yeah, I want to live in West Tennessee where they don't know their ass from a hole in the ground. Let's go to, let's, MC, W.M.C., Memphis. Let's go channel W.R.E.G. News Channel 3, Memphis.
The concrete is not the quick part. It's not...
That picture is breaking up. Oh, yeah, it's digital TV. That's right. They don't want over the air. That's right. That would be too reliable. This way they can control what you see.
And you have these straight-line wind gusts. Now, Jim...
Zoom in on that time.
Mile storm system at this point. We're getting what, 15,000 people? Is that what you told me to call?
Yes. Yes.
Okay, Jim. 15,000 people now reported without power, and the storm system is just really the same.
Okay. See up there, right up in the top screen. Oh, they just went over Jackson.
Not seeing quite as much lightning here.
Right where his bald head is Jackson. But you know, I don't know. We don't worry about that. Let's worry about Mississippi and Arkansas and Memphis. DirecTV sucks. Their local is according to Nielsen's ratings. And Nielsen's rating was probably 25 years ago, okay? So DirecTV and their custom service sucks. Overall, on a 1 to 10 rating, DirecTV with a 10 being great and 1 being bad, I give them a 2. 2 because I can still see some programs sometimes. So anyway, there you go.